everyone. Today I'm going to tell you the story of Saint Lucy of Syracuse. She's the most highly venerated saint in Christianity. Lucy was born in 283 AD to wealthy Roman parents in Syracuse. Her father was a rich Roman man, and her mother, named Eutychia, had Greek origins. They were a very happy family, but their happiness did not last for very long. When Lucy was 5 years old, her father had died. Lucy embraced Christianity from a very young age. It was dangerous to be a Christian during those days. The Romans punished the followers of Christ severely, as it was considered to be a crime. Lucy knew this and kept her faith unknown to anyone, and even from her own mother. Her mother, Eutychia, was suffering from a health disorder. She was either unaware about her daughter's vow or was concerned about her future. As a single woman, she was worried that she might die soon. So, she arranged a marriage to a young man from a wealthy pagan family. Lucy told her mother that Christ was a better partner for her. She convinced her mother to go to the shrine of Saint Agatha so that they could pray for her mother's health. Lucy took her mother to the shrine of Saint Agatha, and they prayed there all night. After a few hours, they both fell asleep near the tomb of Saint Agatha. It was then Lucy had gotten a vision. Saint Agatha had appeared to Lucy in a dream and had told her that her mother was healed, and had also informed her that she was the glory of Syracuse. She woke her mother up and told her about the dream she had. Then her mother told her that she felt no more pain. Then her mother too converted to Christianity. When they reached home, she asked her mother's permission to distribute their wealth among the poor. Her mother tried to convince her to give their riches away in her will rather than right away. She was concerned about how her daughter was going to survive. Lucy then said, "True charity means giving the riches away while I am still alive, not when I am dead and I have no use of them." Her mother agreed and started distributing their wealth among the poor. The bridegroom had gotten the news that their jewels for the wedding was being distributed. He had gotten very angry. He had told the governor about this. He was a very evil man. He had also informed her about Lucy's fate in Christianity. The soldiers brought her to the court, and their trial began. The governor asked her, "Don't you know it's a crime to be a Christian? Do you have anything to say?" Lucy said, "I am true to my faith. No matter what you do to my body, my soul will remain pure." The governor replied, "I will give you one last chance. Make a sacrifice to the idols and announce your faith in front of everyone here." Lucy answered, "I can't do that. I will only make a sacrifice to the Lord Christ, to my good deeds." Hearing this, one of the soldiers slapped her, and she fell to the ground. When the soldiers tried to drag her away, but her body was too heavy for them to lift. The Holy Spirit had made her body heavy and immobile, so it had become impossible to lift. The governor ordered the soldiers to bring her to the stake and burn her alive. One of the soldiers tried to light a fire and burn her, but the light would simply burn. The governor had gotten very angry and ordered the soldiers to tear her eyes out and strike her. Even after that, Lucy continued to pray to God. The soldiers struck her again, and Lucy had come to her death. This had really inspired me. When Lucy's body was prepared for the burial in the family mausoleum, it was discovered that her eyes had been miraculously restored. This is one of the main reasons why Lucy is the patron saint of the blind. Lucy died in 304 AD in Syracuse. Her feast day is in 13th December. In paintings, she's often seen with a golden plate holding her eyes and a branch meaning victory over evil. I hope you learned something about this amazing saint. Let us all live our pain without denying Jesus. Thank you, everyone.